So I wanted to show you guys how to take the picture of planet Uranus. Uranus is like seventh planet from the sun. We are looking into the edge of the solar system when we are trying to take a picture of Uranus. So how do we do that? How do we take a picture of a planet that is so far in the distance? It doesn't matter whether you have C14 or even you have C8 like Celestron 8 or 9.25 or 11, doesn't matter. You should be able to take a good picture of the planet Uranus. So one of the things that I would like to show you guys today is about the setup. How do I make the planetary imaging work, right? In case of planetary imaging, we all knew that, you know, planets are so tiny, and if you wanted to see the moons of the planet, you really wanted to have a Barlow, which is going to make your telescope focal length double or triple, depends on what kind of Barlow that you use. And that's what we need in order to make it work. And if you can see this product here, right here, this is called Teleview PowerMate. So actually this was made by Nagler, John Nagler, I think. He made this actually during the moon or lunar missions for NASA. They don't do anything. Actually, they cancel out pretty much their existence. All they do is they magnify. If it is a 2x, they make it 2 times. If it is a 4x, they make it 4 times of the image really well. All they do is they just magnify it in a perfect way. That's why these are kind of expensive. I think 3 or 4 kinds of PowerMates. They have a 2x, 4x, 2.5x, and also 5x. I think the 2, 2.5, and the 4 are very popular because they are parfocal. So when you have your telescope focused and when you put these PowerMates there, the focus is the same. You don't need to like refocus it. In case of, I think, 5, you may need to refocus a little bit. But besides that, I personally like 2x and 4x, either one of those. In case of this one, this is like a 3000 millimeter focal length. So that makes, by putting a 4x on it, I'm looking at 12,000 millimeters. Let's say if you have Celestron 8SE, if you have a 2000 focal length, you are looking at 8,000 focal length. That's pretty good in order to take a picture of a good planet. So that's what this is for. Even if you connect the Teleview PowerMate, it just cancels out. It's not really going to add anything for your back focus. It just magnifies it, so you're good. So when you buy the PowerMate, you don't get this extra adapter. Like this is called the T adapter. You have to buy the T adapter for your 4X, and there is another PowerMate adapter for 2X. So let me explain you the stack that I did here. So I have my moonlight focuser, and that's where it ends, right here, right? And then I have here, let me take this off for 1 minute. I just put this there so that the cables won't drag. You see here, right here, this is, if you can see it, this is ZWO atmospheric dispersion corrector. What, it's a big name, long name, ADC, ZWO ADC. So what this will do is, you know, whenever you are looking at a picture of a moon or a planet, you know, you see that waves going through the atmosphere, or you may have some color issues. So what this will do is, it has these two tiny knobs here. So when you move slightly these knobs, they actually make like a tiny bit of a correction. So if you buy the ZWO ADC, it comes with these extra things. I removed all of them, and I just use the heart of the ZWO ADC. So if you, this is moonlight focuser, right? It has the M42 thread right here. So the M42 thread in the back of it, and this is the front of it, right? So I just directly, as if I'm screwing the camera, right? So I just do the ZWO adapter here, right? And then on this side, So this is my Star Izona filter slider. That's what I'm using right now. The good thing about it is, like, you can screw this directly into this and the Teleview, the 4X Teleview goes on the other side of your a small adapter that goes from the filter slider to the 4X Power Mate, right? So that's how I'm able to connect this one. I'm just keeping the Teleview right now, but when the Polaris comes in, I'll take the Teleview off. I'll connect this camera directly so that I can do my polar alignment. And once I'm done with my polar alignment, I'll also do a two-star alignment, and I'll show you why. And once I'm done with my two-star or maybe four-star alignment, I will put the Teleview back again. Okay, I'll show you guys that workflow. So we are going to Uranus, and I want to make sure I put this back to the full screen so that if I get an opportunity to see it, and also make it pretty big generally, like around 800 and winning equal to 2, just to avoid opportunity to miss that one. Did you see that? The planet is in the field of view.